Right. So what about the question of jealousy? Do you feel jealous of the other sister wife? And if so, how do you deal with it? Is there any favoritism being played by the general that he's not speaking to us? Is there anything that you would actually like to say that he's actually not speaking to?
To answer that first question, as far as jealousy, yes, I have had plenty of jealousy. And I think just basically being the only one and then someone else coming in. So I've been feeling all kind of ways about that, but something I'm working on to better myself still. And yeah, it's definitely jealousy. The time spent from him being away from us, yeah, it hurts, and something I'm dealing with.
Yeah. So, if it's, I mean, have you guys actually discussed about possibly, actually, if not being in the same place, at least another place that's like, you know, within close vicinity? Because the whole point, to me, the whole point of sister wives, and I'm trying to look into the camera, is that the sisters are supposed to actually be like really sisters, you know, helping each other out and benefiting one when the other one's not feeling well, or if one is actually just exhausted, don't feel like doing dishes or something. Hey, you could, I'll hint at that today. Even if they're not her children, they're still her stepchildren. So, hey, don't worry about the children today. I might have it. You two could actually just go ahead out. I would think from that perspective, it would actually help the relationship because sometimes women feel exhausted, you know, especially when, you know, sometimes of the month, they may just feel down and out and not feel like doing certain things. And so the other sister may be able to pull in it. But what do you guys think about if you guys was actually, if not in the same house, like closer together within a mile or so? Where it, you know, the distance is not so great, or if the house is big enough, you know, I don't see why, you know, being in the same house would actually be a problem. I don't know if that would actually cause more jealousy. What do you guys think about that?
Well, for as being, you know, within a, I say within 10 minutes to a mile of each other. Yeah, that's actually the goal. Ultimate goal is to have a, well, modern day we call like a compound. For you know, for everyone to, you know, be in, we have like an inner court and an outer court, so that is the goal, and that would definitely be, you know, way more beneficial. Because I work pretty, you know, pretty hard at the moment getting certain things established. So yeah, my time is spread, you know, very thin for this time period, but I'll balance that out appropriately, or as you know, most of it leads me. What do you think about it? You think it'd be beneficial if we were in a close vicinity versus in the same household?
I think it would be very much beneficial.
Which one do you think would be better?
Closer.
You got it, folks.
Closer.
Closer. So being closer, but two separate places, would be more beneficial than being on, being like a six, not bedroom.
See.
But I mean, so if I could just interject, wouldn't it be more financially wiser if you was actually, you know, both within the same vicinity, same home, but just had your own spaces? Instead of like being in two different locations, I'm just saying, I mean, if, you know, you're trying to like financially like plan things out, I would think that would be more beneficial. But so I guess my next question would be, since you guys don't want to be in the same house, and I hear that a lot, you know, Rhea was saying something to that extent. So, you know, in a relationship where there's jealousy and jealousy is actually manipulating, you know, your feelings, you may not be able to see all the benefits of polygamy. And I'm pretty sure by now some women out there listening and saying, well, you know, I wouldn't get involved in that anyways. But I would think, just as my opinion, that if you guys was in the same home, if he was actually able to get along well, I think it would be more beneficial financially if he was in the same home. But unless, you know, you're just, I guess, fine with actually just spending more, because the cost of two homes would be much more expensive than one home, a bigger home. You would actually have two different mortgages. You know, then you got to factor in all the property taxes and the upkeep of the homes. So you would actually be upkeeping two homes versus one. I mean, that's just...
No, I do not.
So what do you believe that there's only so much that you could actually help with? You know, let me show you that from a man's perspective. Like, a man may not be in a financial position, you know, at a point in his life where he could actually provide financial assistance for a child, right? Or for a son or a daughter, right? And so a lot of women use that as a weapon against him. And so where he could actually be providing, like, social skills, like teaching them things from a man's perspective, since he's not providing that financial, you know, benefit, the woman doesn't want him to deal with them. And she'll say things like, well, you know, your father's no good. He doesn't provide for you. But at the same time, there's a lot of other things that's more essential than the financial aspects that he could actually provide. And that's proven by, you know, women that rear, you know, single children. They're much more prone to suicide, much more prone to high school dropouts, much more prone to teenage pregnancy, much more prone to drugs and alcohol. The list goes on and on. So all of these things, and the social sciences know this, that, you know, when the father's in the home, that these things are less likely to occur. So even though when he can't provide a financial benefit, he can still provide those other things that's wanting, that, you know, a child, both males and females, need. So, you know, given that right there, so now I guess I'll go back and re-ask you, why do you think you can't provide much now? Because you'll have the same skills now that you have later. You know, later on when you think you could provide those. So do you mean something financially? Or, you know, something like some sort of form of support? Or you're just extremely busy?
I just mean in forms of, like, support, like just spending time with kids and, you know, being there to be able to, like, rear them, you know, so to speak.
Right. So you're saying you don't have time for that? You don't have enough time for that right now?
Because I have to work 5 days a week, and I don't have a working vehicle myself, so I have to go when, you know, our husband is able to take me there.
But all of that could be resolved. That there's, you know, I guess you guys could work through that. That could all be resolved.
Yeah. Okay, so before, you know, like the current little situation, like I said, very temporary. It would be just on the weekends. So specifically between Friday and Sunday is when that, you know, dynamic takes place. So between Monday and Thursday, sometimes Monday through Friday, that's not, you know, that's not the case. So,
right.
But yeah, we definitely practice that in, you know, in preparation for the next step.
Yeah, so let me ask this, Jerrica. So what if you had a baby by him and you had to work? Would you not have time for your biological baby by him because you have to work? Because so when we come into a relationship, like if a man comes into a relationship and he marries a woman that has children, he's assuming the responsibility of those children unless both he and she volunteers that those children go and stay with their father. So he's taking on that responsibility as well. So when you come into a relationship, you're taking on the responsibility of the children that he has also. That's how it should work, because you're actually becoming a part of the life of him and the children. So what if you had a baby biologically with him? Then at the work, would you not spend any time with your biological child?
Yes,
you would.
I would.
You will find some way to make it happen, right? You will find some way to make it happen. You will make it possible. Somehow, you will work on. I'm pretty certain. This is just my thought. I'm pretty certain if you had a baby by him, you will find some way to somehow make that work out. So it's the same case scenario. And since you work, have you been actually working towards like some sort of solution with the transportation? Because when a woman works, right, her finances is actually supposed to come into the home. That's the whole point of being in a polygamous relationship, to help out as well. So what are you doing to actually try to help rectify that situation?
Well, we've discussed a plan, and that plan is currently in motion. Matter of fact, even today, went to like a auction.